Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Lindsay Urban, the director of the Arts Institute of Middlesex County. Welcome to Art and Storytime. Today and all month, we are celebrating women's history, and we are joined by our friends at the Civic League of Greater New Brunswick. Please set your screen to speaker mode. We are recording this session, and if you wish to remain anonymous, please keep your camera off. It's now my pleasure to introduce to you Mr. Sean Hewitt, the director of youth leadership at the Civic League of Greater New Brunswick.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you all for joining us on this slightly rainy day. For those of you that are returning, welcome back to Storytime. For our new guests, thank you for joining us. As mentioned, my name is Sean Hewitt. I'm Director of Youth Leadership with the Civic League of Greater New Brunswick. And the Civic League is responsible for youth programming and supporting African-American and minority youth for over 76 years. And so it is our pleasure to partner with the Art Institute of Middlesex County to facilitate this programming, which we've been doing since February. So for Black History Month, we had some excellent books, and for Women's History Month, it's been an excellent experience. And so I hope you guys enjoy today. I think it'll be a wonderful, wonderful, enriching read and activity. And so I pass it back over to you, Lindsay.
Thank you, Sean. I'm gonna pass the ball on to my colleague, Tracy Oreggio. And Tracy Oreggio-Clark is going to introduce our special guest. We have so many special folks today on for this book reading to close out our Women's History Month. So we are so excited. And here is Tracy.
Hi, everyone. Hi, everyone. Hi, Ms. Rose. Hi, Ms. Abu Rose. Thank you so much for joining us today. And it's my esteemed pleasure and honor to introduce our reader, our special guest. I would like to introduce you to one of, when you think of the people or the person that you look up to most, this person comes to mind immediately in my mind. I'm very, very, very fortunate to know her and that she said yes to being a reader here. She's very fond of the Civic League and is very fond of education, as she has been in education for over 52 years. And I'd like to introduce you to Dr. Penelope Latimer.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's nice to see you. It's my pleasure to be invited to read a book that certainly would be near and dear to my heart, talking about dance and particularly ballet. So I'd like to say to the youngsters who are listening today and viewing us that ballet is my favorite art form. I studied ballet myself from age 3 through adulthood. And so it's been a part of my life. I love all types of music and all types of dance, but in particular, ballet. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth position with feet and with arms is near and dear to my heart, and certain ballet dancers. Now, certainly, I want to say that because of my love of dance and ballet in particular, it was my inspiration for you youngsters attending the New Brunswick Public Schools to have dance as a part of your core curriculum. And so some 30 some years ago, I talked to the New Brunswick Board of Education and Dr. Roy Epps, teachers in New Brunswick schools, the school principals, and we all agreed that bringing dance into the curriculum would be an enrichment. I also talked to members of the Princeton Ballet School who were coming to New Brunswick to start a new studio. And so the leaders of the Princeton Ballet School and the New Brunswick Board of Education, we joined together, and about 35 years ago, Dance Power was born. So Dance Power has been in the city of New Brunswick and the schools for a very long time. Dance Power is indeed in the state of New Jersey. It's the longest arts integration program in a public school district out of 600 school districts throughout New Jersey. Dance Power is the oldest arts education form to be uninterrupted and sponsored by a board of education with a private dance school. So you're a part of something that's historic, very long reaching, and I hope that you're finding it as enriching and as fun as I did to create and to dance. So we should now start to read. So here's our book for today, and I hope that the first thing that you notice is the cover. This beautiful cover, and with this vibrant dancer portraying one of the steps of the classic ballet called Firebird. So Firebird is the title of this book, but Firebird is also a very classic ballet. Misty Copeland is the author of this book, and she made history a few years ago as the first African-American to be named a principal dancer. That means a lead dancer with a major ballet company. And so that company was American Ballet Theater, and that's in New York City. So Misty Copeland, the author of this book, is also a prima ballerina, top ballet performer. And her friend, Christopher Myers, is the one who is the illustrator. So he drew the illustrations that we're going to enjoy as we read this book. So ballerina Misty Copeland, she shows a young girl how to dance like the Firebird. The space between you and me is longer than forever. You are the sky and clouds and air. Your feet are swift as sunlight, stretching across the skyline like the day-long sun over the horizon. Me, I'm gray as rain, heavy as nap time, low as a storm pressing on rooftops. I could never hope to leap the space between. Let's see how sad she looks. But here, Misty speaks to her. Darling child, don't you know you're just where I started? Let the sun shine on your face. Your beginning's just begun. So here, Misty is giving this little girl encouragement and telling her that her beginnings have just begun. Before the curtain rises, before the spotlight falls, before the fireworks of costumes, before it all. I was a dancer just like you, a dreaming shooting star of a girl with work and worlds ahead. There I am, sweating at the bar. I had 1,000 leaps and falls, switching worn out slippers, swift as applause. So now this bar is spelled B-A-R-R-E. And those of you who are studying dance and ballet know that the bar is where we go first thing to warm up our bodies, right? Even birds must learn to fly like me. You'll grow steady in grace, spread an arabesque of wings and climb. And so I hope you know that arabesque is a very particular step that we do, right? Each position, 1 through 5, stair steps to the sky. That's right. And here these young ladies are demonstrating the 5 positions. You will soar, become a swan, a beauty, a firebird for sure. Soon with the same practice, you'll join me in this dancing dream. In a pas de deux, a music box for 2. So the French phrase pas de deux is very important in ballet, and that means just 2. So 2 people dancing together. In a pas de deux, a music box for 2, we will wrap our hearts careful as ribbons on point shoes. We'll make the night sky our starry curtain, the moon our silver spotlight, as we spin across the planets, pirouetting tightly as the pearls on our heads. And we know that a pirouette is a turn, a quick turn that we do, right? So pirouetting tightly as the pearls on our heads. Spinning wishes for new little ones we can't yet imagine. Then they will look to you and wonder. Lighter than air and swift as sunlight, turning over the day and say, the space between you and me is longer than forever, and I will show them that forever is not so far away. And so you see that the older dancer and the younger dancer have closed the space between them and are able to dance together. Isn't that beautiful? Now, so we have finished the story, but at the back of this book written by Misty Copeland, this African-American female who's made history by being the first principal dancer to be named by a major ballet company, American Ballet Theatre. And so she writes a letter to everyone who reads this book. And in this letter, she says that I was once a little girl searching for my voice. And then she goes on to talk about what studying ballet has meant to her, and how it has enriched her life. And I relate to this because I began to study ballet when I was 3 years old, as I told you, and I continued to study through college. But I want you to know that the lessons that I learned, like this letter from Misty Copeland to you, those lessons stay with me through all of my adult years. And what I learned in ballet class and in dance class about personal discipline, about being able to follow directions, to work together in unison with others in class, and to take criticism so that I can always become a better dancer or a better thinker. And above all, dance of all forms help you to have a very healthy lifestyle, respecting your body and being good to yourself. So I hope you've enjoyed hearing me read to you this book, Firebird, a beautifully illustrated book. And this picture and this letter is a picture of the real Misty Copeland, who is still dancing with American Ballet Theatre in New York City. She is about in her 32 years old or so. So she's still a very, very strong dancer, but she began as a little girl, just like many of you. I'd like to now introduce to you Ms. Lindsay Cahill, who is also a talented dancer and a leader of Dance Power Program, a graduate of Rutgers University, and she's going to now help you to dance a little bit this afternoon and to imagine yourself as Misty Copeland was asking the young dancer to imagine dancing with her.
Thank you so much, Dr. Latimer. I really appreciate that. And all the words that you just spoke about what dance means to you and how it made you feel, that's exactly what we all go through as dancers. And it's so wonderful that you were able to express it the way that you did. I'm so happy again to be here and to be a part of this program with you all. Again, Dance Power is possible because of Dr. Latimer and because of American Repertory Ballet's partnership with New Brunswick Board of Education. And this year is our 35th anniversary. So it is an amazing year. We made it to 35. So it's a truly special year. And it's a little different now because, again, our program has kind of changed to virtual. But again, that hasn't, you know, we haven't stopped the beat here. But I just want you to know that with our program, we're able to teach the history of ballet. We're able to teach the language, try new movements. And again, at the end of our 20 weeks together, we normally put on this big show called Waiting in the Wings. And again, at that big show, we are able to give out some scholarships. And again, this is a reward for you and all your hard work that you were able to put into our 20 weeks time together. And through this scholarship, you are actually able to take dance lessons, ballet classes with Princeton Ballet School from fourth grade up until 12th grade. So that is a pretty special reward. And again, something that I hope that all of our dancers feel really accomplished once they get. And if you're interested in any more information, you can always go to our website, arballet.org, all right, for any more information on our performances and programs. So let's just jump into some movement, everyone. What we need for ourselves right now is just a little bit of space, all right? And again, just a reminder, if I do anything that is too large or too much for your space, you can modify that and make it just a little smaller to fit in where you are in your space, all right? So what we're going to do is we are going to be using music, all right, from Misty Copeland's favorite composers. All right. She loved Tchaikovsky and Stravinsky. So we're going to start ourselves off with something by Tchaikovsky called 1812 Overture. Okay. And what we're going to do is we're going to welcome ourselves to the space. And to do that, we're going to take a couple of breaths. All right, we're gonna breathe in our good energy and breathe out some nice grounded energy. So that way, when we get to our ballet movements, we're really ready to go. All right, so I'm gonna play some music on. All right, hopefully you'll hear that coming on through your speaker. Now again, it is nice and calm and quiet. This is Tchaikovsky, and you'll notice through this music that it grows to grand and then back to small. All right, so there's a bunch of different tempos and instruments that you'll hear along the way. So again, just enjoy that music as well. And let's begin, everyone, by taking a nice deep breath in through our nose and out through our mouth. Good. Let's do that again, everyone. In through our nose and out through our mouth. Good. Now, each class, I always pick a word of the day. And I think today's word is determined. All right. Having a strong feeling that you are going to do something and that you will not allow anyone or anything to stop you. You have to remember, just like Misty Copeland, she was super determined to become who and what she is today. And again, let's take another deep breath in and out. And let's be determined to have a great time together today. And remind yourself, if you put your mind to it, you can do it. All right, last breath in and out. Excellent. Again, hopefully we're feeling nice and welcome to our space. we are going to now move into some warm-ups and some stretches, all right? So again, let's back ourselves up away a little bit from your screen, if you would like. And what we're going to do is begin with a nice, gentle circle of the head. You pick your direction and let it circle all the way around. Again, warming up all of those neck muscles, making sure that we're ready to keep a nice lift in our chin for, again, when we begin our ballet movement. Let's reverse that circle, everyone. Opposite direction, all the way around. Good, and do that one more time. Nice. All right, excellent. Let's settle our head down back to center. And let's move on, everyone, into those shoulders. Let's begin to warm up our shoulders by rolling them out. We can already hear the music and the intensity building, right? Excellent. Rolling those shoulders, good. And let's reverse those movements, coming on forward. Nice, everyone. Good work. Moving on from there, we're gonna do some full arm circles if you can in your space. Excellent, again, warming up from those shoulders all the way down to our fingertips, reversing these big circles, everyone. Good, opening up our chest, our back muscles. Excellent. Now let's take our hands and clasp them together and bring our hands to our heart space and look up and gaze towards our sky. Again, opening up our chest, nice deep breath. Excellent. And let's take our fingers apart and shake them out a little bit. Good. Making sure our fingers are ready for some graceful ballet movement. Awesome. Let's drop those hands now down by your side, everyone. And what I need you to do is stretch your arms out and let's take a nice gentle stretch to one side of our space. Nice. Bringing our body back up center, stretching as long as you can all the way to the other side, really reaching out for that wall. Good, bringing our body back up center, stretching our hands up to the sky, and now reaching towards our camera, all the way to the floor if you can. That's it, rising up to our spine. And stretching on out again, arms out. Arms up, everyone. Stretching up and over towards your camera, all the way down towards that floor if you can. Taking a nice gentle breath right there. Slowly again, rising up through our spine. Excellent. Again, our bodies should feel nice and open and loose. What we're going to do is we're going to sit down really quick. If anyone has any seated space, I want to try these three stretches with you to work on a little bit of flexibility. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to sit on down. Look, I'm putting the bottoms of my feet together. And this movement is called a butterfly. And this is one of the stretches a lot of dancers work on because we want to work on our range of motion in our hip flexors. And from here, what we're going to do is take a nice gentle breath in and out and stretch on over to see if we could get our nose close to our toes. And again, as a dancer, we just relax there to loosen up those back muscles, breathing on out, letting those muscles feel that stretch, slowly rising up through our spine. And then we're going to move on into our second stretch, which is our pike stretch, where we stretch our legs straight out in front of us. And again, now we're going to swipe our legs to glue them together side by side. Now, everyone, wiggle your toes to wake up your feet, making sure they have really good energy for, again, when we get to all those ballet movements that have to do with our ankles and our feet. Everyone, now let's move into what we call a flex, where our toes are stretching up to the ceiling, and then we're going to try a point to where our toes point towards the floor and stretch over. So again, let's try a flex and a point, and again, flex. And points. Your music is getting super exciting for us. No wonder why Misty Copeland loved this composer, right? Another flex and another point and shake those feet out. Excellent. Let's find our feet in that pointed position. Stretch your hands high above your head, stretching up and over all the way, seeing if you could reach your fingertips to your toes. Nice. Stretching, taking a little breath right there, bringing our bodies back up. And our third and final stretch, everyone, is your straddle. where your legs look like they're in the letter B shape. All right, we're stretching our knees super straight. They're facing the ceiling, and we're trying to keep our toes, if we can, in a pointed position. Stretching our arms out, reaching up and over to one side, and then doing a nice part up and over to the other. Good, it's like a big rainbow through your space. Stretching up and over from one leg to the other. Excellent, feeling the stretch in your sides and in your legs. Excellent. Let's bring our body center and let's walk our hands out, seeing how far we can stretch our hands in front of us. And we're going to hold in this stretch, even looking towards the floor if you can, seeing how close you can get to that ground. Here we go, everyone. Let's hold this stretch for 1, 2, and 3. Rising on up, closing those straddle legs, giving a nice gentle bounce out to release and relax those muscles, finding ourselves in a crisscross really quick, taking a nice deep breath in and out. Excellent. Hopefully everyone is feeling nice and stretched. Again, we should feel looser, right? From our standing warm-up. And then when we sat for our seated stretches, hopefully you're feeling a little more flexibility in your legs, feeling a little taller with our posture. And also stretching and warming up helps with injury prevention. So it's really important for dancers to do that each time before they get into their movement and more exercises. So everyone, we are now going to jump right in to some ballet movements. Has anyone ever heard or taken ballet before? I'm pretty sure there are some dancers in here. Yeah, you can definitely throw it in the chat. That's perfect. Awesome. So we have some dancers here. I love it. And guess what? Even if not, no worries. All right. We're going to learn just some, you know, basic movements and things to get ourselves, you know, a little familiar with our ballet. Okay. So everyone, what we're going to do is I'm going to teach you 2 positions of the feet. Okay. Then we're going to move into some movement of the arms, which we call porte-bras. All right. Then we're going to learn something called a plié, something called a tendu, and something called an élevé. All right. Now, these terms, they are not English words, right? That porte-bras, plié, tendu, élevé, all of those are French vocabulary words, right? Because again, ballet began in France. So that's why we normally use those terms to describe our exercises and movements, all right? So here's what I need everyone to do. Can everyone stand up on your feet, all right? Because these exercises have to do with us standing up, all right? So what I want you to do is, if you notice, my feet right now are in a parallel position. They're facing straight forward towards my camera and my computer, right? But what we're going to do is learn the first position of ballet, and it actually is called first position. What you're going to do is take one of your feet, and again, this is my right foot, and I'm going to place my right foot towards the right direction. Then I'm going to take my left foot and place my left foot towards the left direction. From there, I'm going to look down and see if I can then glue my heels side by side together. And if you notice, this resembles, again, that letter V, right? So again, looking down, making sure we have a nice turnout, right? In that right direction and in the left. Let's place our arms now in a certain position. Can everyone round your arms nice and low by your belly? Now, when you're holding your arms in this position, look, it looks like a nice round circle. Now, this is normally how we always begin our ballet warm-up exercises, with our arms rounded in our low fifth position, and then our feet placed in our first position. Excellent. It looks like we've got our first position down. Now I'm going to teach you your next position, which is called second position. Now, if you noticed, all I did was open my feet just a little bit of a hip width apart, having my toes still facing in that turned out position. Now we're also going to stretch our arms all the way out in this position, which is also second position arms. So now our arms and our feet are in second position. Now, can everyone, as quickly as they can, jump back to first position? Let's see if we can find it. Excellent. And let's see if we can jump to second position. Let's see if we can find it really quick. All right, very good. Excellent. So let's relax, shake that out. So those are our first two positions. Now, porte-bras. Everyone in your space, just say that out loud on the count of three. Ready? One, two, three. Porte-bras. Now, porte-bras is the movement of your arms. So if you can find your feet back to your first position, arms are in your low fifth. For our arm movement, our porte-bras, we're going to bring our arms up through first position. Can everyone hold their arms out just like this, almost as if it's a big round basketball hoop? That way, like a basketball could fit right in that space. These are first position arms. From here, we're going to open our arms nice and gracefully to our second, and then lower our arms back down to our low fifth. All right. So again, let's try that movement together. Lifting up and open and lower back down. Excellent. Now moving right along, we have a plié. Now, our plié simply means to bend. Everyone knows how to bend their knees, right? So again, let's think we have our arms stretching out to our second. Oh, actually, just kidding. We'll keep them down here in our low fifth for now. Let's try a bend of the knees. Here we go. We're going to create a diamond shape and then straighten and stand all the way stretching back tall. So let's try that again. Plié is a bend. And then stretching back up straight. Try that one more time. Plié, bend, and then stretching all the way back to straight. Excellent. Let's find that second position again. Remembering when those feet were apart and our arms were out, let's see if we could try a plié in this position. Just a nice, simple demi-plié, which is just a little bend of the knee. Good. Let's try one more, everyone. Excellent. And now let's bring our feet back to that first position. Very good. We're moving right along. We're doing really well so far. Now we have two more moves to do. Remember, we're going to move and learn a tendu now. All right. So our tendu means to stretch. So watch this one. In your first position, arms are stretching out straight. See if you can try this. You're going to take one of your legs and stretch it out to the side of your space with a pointed toe. From there, you take that stretched leg and you bring it back to your first position. So again, tendu is to stretch out, keeping your toe pointed on the floor, and then bringing it smoothly back into first position. Let's try the other leg. Tendu stretching out to one side of your space, and then again, bringing it back to that first position close. Try that one more time. Tendu outstretch and bringing it back to your first position. Excellent. Okay, our final movement is going to be our élevé. Now, our élevé, everyone, requires some balancing. So hopefully we're ready to feel this nice, strong balance and we're able to hold this without losing any kind of control, right? So again, finding ourselves in our first position, we are going to take our arms and again, using that porte-bras movement to bring them all the way up to what we call high fifth. Now they're round arms high above your head, just like the sunshine. And just like the sunshine, we're going to rise up off of our heels, trying to find our balance. And we're going to hold it there for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, then you slowly lower your heels back to the ground and finish. Whew. Oh, that was a lot of information right there. I'm hoping that everyone was able to follow right along because here's what we're going to do. We're going to take those movements, all right, and we're going to put them together, which again, we're going to kind of call this a little bit of choreography right now, because again, choreography is planned steps and movements, all right, and then we have a certain order, we put them to music, and we pretend like we're doing our own little performance right here and right now with one another, all right? So if you can, try and follow along with me. Here's the order and choreography that we're going to use for our ballet warm-up. We're going to start in our first position, our low fifth arms, all right? And remember, this is like our performance routine. So see if you can do all of these movements just like me. Ready? Bring your arms up through first, opening them all the way out to your second, and then lowering them back down to your low fifth. From there, we're going to do three pliés. We're going to bend and stretch, plié again, and then you have one more. Good. From there, we're going to tendu and open to second position, and then we're going to do three more pliés. Plié, bend, and stretch again, and you have one more. Good. And then moving right on back to your first position. Now we are going to do our tendus. We're going to do three tendus, stretching all the way out to one side of your space, adding a plié in the middle, and then continuing to the other side. Tendu out, stretching all the way to our end of our space. Good. With that nice stretch, pointed toe, and our plié. From there, what we are going to do is move right into our élevé. So we're going to open our arms, lower them, and rise all the way up. And again, holding for that count of eight, and then coming on down to finish. All right, everyone, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to play some music for us. Okay. And let's see. This music selection is going to be, I think this one is another one of Misty Copeland's favorites. It's Sleeping Beauty. So this is, again, by Tchaikovsky, the composer. So here we, hold on. Does Antonia have a question? I just want to make sure we get all our questions in.
No, but I have a Misty Copeland book.
Oh, you have that? Great.
Excellent. I'm so glad. That's awesome. All right, everyone, get ready. Ooh. I am going to play our song. All right. Hold
one
on.
One more question, Lindsay. One more question.
Oh, sorry. Go
Wait,
ahead.
Lindsay, one more question. Hi, Miss Maya. How are you doing?
Hi. I just have a surprise at the end.
Okay.
Oh, we can't forward. Wait to see it, right? All right, everyone, let's jump right into it. I'm going to place our song on and you can just follow along. I'll lead you through it. All right, so our song is going to start off soft and quiet. Now, again, we're just using this as our nice background music again because these are Misty Copeland's favorites. So here we go, everyone. Let's try that little bit of choreography for our ballet warm-up we just worked on. Taking a nice breath in and out. Excellent. Getting ready for the grace to come through our movement. And here we go, lifting our arms up through that first, opening all the way wide to your second, and lowering those arms back down to that low fifth. Good. We're going to slowly begin our pliés. Bend and stretch while we listen to that beautiful harp music in the background. And you have one more. Good, opening up nice and wide to that second position. Again, adding in those pliés, and again, and one more. Good, coming on back to your first position, and now let's tendu. Good, we have three of them on this side, and plié, other side. Good, adding in that plié, stretching our arms out, lowering, getting ready to rise up, everyone, to finish it out with our élevé, holding it there. Excellent. Try to keep that control. And let's land on down in our first position and finishing with those arms down. Clap for yourselves, everyone. excellent job. That was like our it was like our first performance all together, right? How did we look? Who enjoyed that one? Excellent. I loved it. Okay, so now, again, I know we don't have too much time left, everyone, but we just kind of talked a little bit about like choreography and set moves and steps, right? But now I want to see a little bit of your creativity, everyone. It's time to kind of create and explore a little bit. Can everyone come close to their cameras? What I want to do right now is kind of test everyone and see, this is probably an easy test for you, but I want to see our expressions, right? We all know what happy looks like with our faces. Who can show me what happy looks like with your face? What would that look? Yes, see those big smiles? Absolutely, that's exactly what happiness is. What about sadness? Mm-hmm. Right away, did you see how all of our faces went from uplifting with that happy to all of a sudden feeling this sadness, right? A little bit of heaviness on ourselves. What about if you were excited? What would excited look like on your face? Yes, good. What about scared? What would scared look like? Okay, good. Now, that was just a little test and everyone passed so successfully. So good job. Now, I want you to think about this. If I asked you to show me what your whole body would look like using those expressions, that's what we're gonna try right now. So everyone, if you can, back yourself up a little bit from your screen and camera. And what I want you to do is with your whole body, let's start with excited. What would your whole body look like if it were to move with excitement? What would you look like if your whole body was like, I just won $1 million? Yeah. Do you see how everyone's going up and down? I love it. Excellent. We're having a party right there. What about if your whole body was to feel sad? You're sad. Like things did not go right today. And again, it's a little gloomy out. See how my body just all of a sudden wants to hang and again, feel a little heavy, right? Now, what if your whole body was scared? What would you look like if your whole body was scared? I might even have my shaking knees on, right? So everyone, listen, here's what I want you to think about. Dancers use their expressions to portray their characters through their ballets and movements. And again, as dancers, we don't use our mouths to speak. We use our bodies to speak, all right? So again, certain music can kind of lead your body to feel a certain way. And we're gonna do a quick exercise that's gonna kind of use a little bit of your creativity. And it's kind of something we'll call improvisation, which again, is free movement, something that comes to your mind in the moment. There's no set steps. This is not like our choreographed ballet warm-up that we just did. This is something completely from you and from you right now in the moment. All right, so here's what we're gonna do. I am gonna put on, now here's the cool thing. We have some music from Firebird, all right, from the story we just kind of, you know, talked about or read with Dr. Latimer. Now we're going to learn and hear some music from that. And what I want you to do is be creative as you can. And whatever you're feeling, let that come out through your movement, all right? So this is up to you to create and explore right now. All right, here we go. Let's see how this music makes you feel. What do we think? What would you want to move like? Anything you want. Spinning in your space. Move your arms. And let's freeze. Whew. All right, I'm gonna keep going. Let's see what your feeling and movements connect with this song from Swan Lake. much different, right, than that first one. How would your body move and tell a story to this song? Nice. Excellent. All right, I'm freezing right there. That was completely different movement, right? And feeling from that first selection we heard, right? Now, hold on. Let's do one more. Here's another one from Firebird. Let's see how this one makes you feel. This feels a little sneaky. And let's pause right there. All right, that one was almost like a combination of both, I feel, right? Oh my goodness, everyone, I had so much fun moving with you today and you all had such great energy. So thank you so much for sharing that with me. Oh, I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much, Miss Lindsay. That was wonderful.
Does anyone have any quick questions for Miss Lindsay? If you want to put it in the chat or you want to unmute yourself. Did you mention it before? I have a question. Did you mention it before? How old were you when you started dancing? I'm sorry if you said it.
You know what? I probably didn't even mention because I wanted to dance so bad. I started dancing when I was 2 years old. My mom put me into ballet lessons. So just a little munchkin. And I just kept going ever since.
Thank you. Thank you so much for your time. And Dr. Latimer, thank you so much for being our special guest and Lindsay being our special guest. I know everyone enjoyed themselves and it was just a great experience. Thank you so much to everyone who's included and joined us today. We had quite a bit of people. I think maybe the rain and, you know, just being in this positive space, we look forward to Wednesday every week. And we will have a reading next Wednesday at the same time, just an ode to Ayana, a different link. And Sarah, if you want to pull up that book. And thank you again, Lindsay. And thank you, Dr. Latimer. Did everyone have a good day today? Hi, Maya. Oh, Maya, the surprise.
Yes, hold on. Let me change my background. Okay. Nothing works because of my background. Okay, now it'll work.
Explain what it is. Explain your art.
It's a ballerina.
Oh, I love it.
The legs are breaking and the way I cut it.
It's beautiful.
Very.
Thank you, Maya.
Okay, so I have the book ready.
Antonia, you had a question?
I have it too.
Oh. Look at you.
Ooh. Stuff on stars.
So this will be the book for next week. Miss Lindsay, do you want to briefly talk about the supplies for next week and what people should expect?
Yes. So this is a beautiful book. And as you can see from the illustration here, almost all the illustrations in this book are done with something called marbled paper. And so that's a special kind of painted, designed paper. And you can see it's really swirly and really interesting and colorful and has like little drips and liquid. It almost looks like a pool of oil or something like that. And so we're actually next week gonna make some marbled paper on screen with you all, and you can try it at home. And so when you register for next week, you're gonna get an optional supply list just like you always do. And if you have time, you can get these supplies ahead of time and you can actually try this at home. And if you don't have time, that's okay. You can watch us, you can join us, and we're gonna try it. It is messy, so I'll warn you, you want to put down some protective, you know, plastic, even a trash bag. If you have a trash bag, you put that over your table so you don't get your table stained. And you want to wear clothes that you don't mind getting dirty. And so some of the supplies, you'll see the full list, but some of the supplies are kind of unusual supplies. They're not really things that you would think of for art, like shaving cream is one of the supplies. And then food coloring is another supply. So these aren't really art supplies, but you can also use paint and you're gonna use chopsticks, so, or a pencil. So there's a lot of different kind of interesting and unusual materials for this activity. But like I said, if you don't have those materials or if you can't get them in time, don't worry about it. You're gonna have a lot of fun just watching us make a huge mess over here of ourselves. And so we're excited for that activity. And it's always something that you can do when you register. Not only will you get the supply list, but you'll also get the instructions so that if you wanna do it at home later, and you'll probably need a parent's help with this or a grandparent or somebody to help you. But if you wanna do it at home later, you can do it anytime you like. And you can always share your artwork with us. We love to see it. So we look forward to that. Wish us some luck in getting messy next time and cleaning up too. We'll need all the help we can get.
Wonderful. Well, thank you everyone for joining us. And we'll be sending out our follow-up email shortly. Let me just drop the link for the Women's History Month .gov page. So everyone, next week is our final week of the month, which is crazy. But you know, we'll be continuing in April, so we'll be doing Poetry Month, so we are going to keep going. Yeah, thank you so much for joining us, everyone. Feel free to send us an email if you have any questions, and yeah.
Thank you, Dr. Latimer. Thank you, Ms. Cahill, for joining us, and thanks everybody, all of our guests. We had a blast today.